Hey, hello guys, and thank you so much for coming to another one of my videos. Today I actually want to go random, so I'll just wait until the time runs out, and if I'm not mistaken, I should get, I'm supposed to get a champion at random. If it just cancels out and sends me out, whatever, right? We'll queue again. So it gave me gear. Okay, so we're gonna play gear today, regardless of the match, like the matchup, how long the fight is. I will just go ahead and record it for you guys, okay? So far, it's not looking good. It's gonna be Terra. Terra is she's very powerful, just because of the ultimate, just because of that. I don't see any other thing to be afraid of. So I'm afraid I actually have to get Magical Shield. The reason is that Magical Shield is going to take from that ultimate, because most of the time I will keep my distance. I am not going to get, oh, she's not even here. What's up, brother? What was that? That's a nice, beautiful leg. Okay, whatever, right? Nothing happened. We just stole her potion. You just gave her a basic thing. If not, there you go. Okay, it's been a while since I last played Gare. Gare was one of my favorite champions. I thought that he was pretty good. And I still do think that he's pretty good. Like right here, you can just stun. Fire, burn. I think Gear is very powerful. Not a lot of people play this champion, but I think it's a very good champion. I think it's better than a lot of what other guys play. And the only thing is that it actually requires for you to aim the abilities. It's not like automatic abilities, except the ultimate. The ultimate, as long as they're in range, you're gonna be able to hit everything. Like, well, it bounces. It bounces between enemies and it has a maximum amount of bounces. If I level up my first ability, I will increase the duration of the stun. And if I level up my second ability, I'll just be increasing the damage on my second ability, if I'm not mistaken. What should I get? I'm gonna go for... Hold on. I don't know. But the other person is keeping, like, I'm gonna go for cool. Okay. here you go. I don't know. I think that the other person is playing, like, they're not doing good. I don't think they know how to play. So I'm honestly not paying attention to them. So, but I just wanted to play, I guess, live. Or pretend that it was live. For example, this is a matchup that he came up, and this is the match that I will stick to. The reason is that I am actually... I just wanted to talk to you guys for a little bit, and I was trying to see what video I had of me so that I could show you while I was talking. So I decided to do the following. Since that was going to be time wasted, I decided to record a fight while I was fighting. That way I can kind of tell you what I'm trying to do. Like right here, if she's going to get close to me, so the best way to punish her is to use our stun. Because we don't want her, right? We don't want her close. So every time that she comes close to us, even a little bit, we're going to punish her. And just hard way, like go balls deep. If they decide to stay, chances are that they're gonna die. Because Garrett can combo like strongly and very often. Especially if you carry CDR like in this situation. Like right here, still have my stun. I'm not gonna use it, see? So we were able to run away.
If she had used the ultimate, I don't think she'll be able to dish a lot of damage out. Just because of the fact that she doesn't have any power. power. She has lifesteal. Well, she started with lifesteal. So you lose power, you gain lifesteal. So she's not going to hurt a lot. And also, she had used her first ability. So whenever she would teleport to me, no, baby. This is not good for her because she's taking so much damage from the minion. Like right there, she's going to die. See? It's just because of the way that you can combo with this champion that I like it.
This is one of my favorite champions. It was one of my first champions. And just because of the way that I play now, I seem to enjoy this champion a little bit more. Like, it's you can abuse the abilities that he has, especially because you can build cooldown on it. And the stun of the first ability is actually pretty high. I actually don't remember what's the exact number. Like, don't be afraid to use your abilities. You have to mark your dominance, I guess. Because he's very dominant. And she's very dominant as well, but I don't think they know how to play the champion. Because they're not doing much. Like, I don't know. Well, whatever, guys. So the reason why I wanted to talk to you, it's because I've
been checking the Chinese server, and I'm going to make a video of all of the things that I have seen over there. First, it already has been announced that there is going to be another champion added to the game. It's like the tank cruiser or a fighter. Sorry for that aim. The rule.
Warrior.
Yeah,
I think he's a warrior.
Not sure. Because many of the
roles that I see in the game that I think are something, they're actually something else.
Really unusual.
But just try checking the roles that all of the champions have, and some are different than from what I expected. For example, Benyu is listed as an assassin. So, yeah. So that's my assassin, I guess. Yes, the reason why I wanted to talk to you, it's because I wanted to let you guys know that I'm gathering information from the other servers. The thing is that I want to see what will be coming to the game, because we haven't been updated as much. Just for a while, we didn't get any updates. And right now, they decided to give us some updates. I think it's going to be tomorrow, but I'm not quite sure. I'm honestly not paying much attention to the forums of the NA server. I'm checking the other ones. I'm going for the good information. Like, there are going to be new skins for Borrowed? A new skin for... It's for... What's his name? Let me think about it, guys. Hold on. I know I'm going to remember. Is the fat guy that... he pulls you... The second ability, it's fire. No, it's not fire, it's like a poison gas. It's chilly in here. Come to me, baby. Doesn't matter, baby. Punish me all you want. I can punish you back. Oh, that bleeding though. Bleeding! Nice. Okay. So this is finally getting interesting. Let's see, we're gonna go for this. Okay, there you go.
Or, in fact, since they don't have armor, we can go all fucking out,
right?
As much ability as you can. Okay, guys, now I'll start playing against her because she appears to be doing good. What the hell? What is that?
Was I lagging? She's low on mana, so she has to go back. Okay. So for now, let me just destroy this person because they're actually getting in my nerves now. You know what? Fuck the minions. We want that person. There you are. What are you gonna do? Now, we're powered. We go back again. What are you gonna do? Hey, what are you gonna do, baby? And I'm away right here, baby. Don't you worry, don't you worry. Here you are. I have her locked, right? I'm full fucking focus on her. Oh, she moved. Okay, I I see, baby. I see what you're doing. In this case, I'm gonna get this, I'm gonna get this. Is it 30? How much? Oh, she already destroyed it. Well, I should not let her get my. There you go, guys. So I like Gear because of the ability that he has and the way that he can combo. Now, right here, this is what usually happens. I start a game and the game doesn't seem to be interesting. And then I notice that we're just making some mistakes, right, here and there. Like, we always do mistakes. But they end up doing even better than what we expect. Because they grow, right? And the way that they build. At the beginning, I did notice that she was going for lifesteal. So I was assuming that she will continue to be building lifesteal. Now, the mistake that I made is that I actually was not keeping up with her build. Because I was just talking, right? So when I look at the build, I noticed that she was going for critical. And that was a very good choice. Now, the third item was Power of the Gods. That item is also very, very fucking good for her. So those three items that she had, including the boots, of course, they were good choices, okay? Actually, they're very good choices for her. So when I noticed that the build was a good build or a good mid build, I noticed that maybe that player didn't know how to use her. So my mistake is that I assumed that this person didn't know how to play. So they did very well. They actually almost defeated us. That was scary. I'm sorry if that I had to go mute for a while. The thing is that this is the reason why I don't make videos while playing.
And I wanted to try it out. I wanted to see if I could do it, but it seems that like I couldn't. I go into the fights. Like I start like I pay close attention. Okay? So I pay close attention and I just get lost. Let's see what we have here. I forgot to share the fight. That was the whole purpose. It was for first win of the day. And then for sharing sharing on Facebook, because I do those things, guys. Like I don't I rarely play the game, but when I do play the game, I try to make it effective, right? I try to go for the first win of the day. I try to share it. I try to see if I could get one or two fights in 3v3 so I can start getting those events, because those events are actually pretty good. Like they have helped me get a lot of champions. They have helped me get pretty much almost all the champions. So they're free. Just do it, guys, whenever you have a chance. Right now, we're going to stick to the same rule. I'm not going to pick anything. But as you can see, there are many options from... Oh, this is the name. This is the guy. The name was Patch. So, going back to that. So, I was checking the Chinese server. And it seems like there are a lot of things that are going to be coming to... hold on, guys. I need to plug in my phone because of the battery. Fuck yeah, right? Raglan. Raglan is OP, right? Let me see if I can... I need a chair. Oh, against another Raglan? Hold on. There you go, guys. Sorry, I had to go get a chair. So this is gonna be interesting, guys. Yeah. So again, I was checking the Chinese servers, and I did notice that they were gonna be adding a lot of. they were gonna be adding a lot of new skins into the game. One of the skins that I thought it was pretty funny, it was one that it was for Patch. It was a football player Patch, and I think it was pretty good, guys. I honestly do. Now, he only has the stun. He used it already. And he missed it. I actually don't like to go for that one first, right? Because it's not a thing that you want to do. Like right here, look at the damage that we can dish out. Look at this. And if he gets closer, look at this. I'm sorry, guys, but the thing is that I don't use Raglan very often, but honestly, this is a very, very good champion to do 1v1s. There are many champions that are very good at 1v1. Okay, they actually excel on that, and the main thing is that you have to know what your abilities do. My second ability, it's a buff that makes my next basic attack a range attack that it slows the enemies. And also, if you don't remember what your abilities do, you can also check on the description, which is in the middle of the screen to the right. The first one, I know what it does. It's a wall, it stuns the enemy, it has a duration, I think it's 4 seconds. The second one is a spammable buff that makes your next next basic attack a range attack, and it's also an AoE attack. My ultimate is pretty much an earthquake. It pulls enemies in, and the stun that you give out is pretty nasty, guys, actually. It's pretty nasty. That's not how you do it, bro. That's not how you do it. You stun whenever you have him like this. Like this. Like this. Like this. You have to be paying a lot of attention to whatever. Oh, the, what the hell? There was a minion. What, the minion was not inside? Ah, what the hell? Okay. Well, we're not gonna pay attention to that. So the next thing that we want, I like to be fast, and I want this item right here as well. So I'm gonna do that. We're gonna have fun today, guys. We're just gonna play the game and enjoy the match. Worry about nothing else, right? Ah, oh, damn, the ultimate right there will be crazy. I'm not gonna kill those minions just because of the fact that the more minions that he has, the higher my ultimate is. The higher the damage on the ultimate is, the more enemies it hits. So yeah, going to that description that I was telling you about is right here. You can pretty much read it right there. There's the descriptions. So if you like, I can start showing that before I start the match so that you can read that. Instead of having to understand whatever the heck I'm saying, right? Just to tell you that you can check there. Is that it? He's mad. I'm sorry, you guys. He's gonna be super mad, right? Let's see. What do you have now? Oh, he's already going for armor.
Don't be a bitch, bro. Don't be a bitch.
That's one of the things that I hate. The champion already is fucking OP, and you go and build full defense. Like, that's very shitty.
Hey, for example, the other time, there are different champions that excel in 1v1. Raglan does very well in 1v1. Selkus does very well in 1v1. Bractalur, also Kandar, also Dressler, also who else? Oh, Mikiri, he fucking the god of 1v1. He can make you just disappear in a few seconds like that. He's crazy, right? Right here, we just want to spam our second ability on the enemy.
Because it procs our
Oh, Trollbane. So that hit that I give is higher than what he does to me. Like right here, the more things I hit, the better it is. So right here, I think I can defeat him as well, look. Oh no, I couldn't. But you can see that the damage that I do is way higher than what he does. Like right there. Like right there. Right here, bro. Where are you going? Okay, so going back to that, there are champions that excel in 1v1, and I think it's very low of people to just abuse the fact that not only they excel at everything. Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh baby!
He's gonna be mad. Not only do they excel at everything, but it also makes you think
that they're desperate to win a fight.
For example,
the other day I fought a champion. I fought against a player, and he was using Selkus, and he used full defense Selkus. He got, first of all, he got flame armor. Then I think he went for the armor that
gives you damage back. I forget the name, but I should be able to check
here. He went for this one. He went for blade armor. He went for adrenaline heart. And then he got, I think it was executioner or something else, I guess. And I mean, I had a freaking hard time defeating that person. He actually, I actually lost that match. It was awful, guys. Like, you have no idea. And the thing that they were abusing is that you can pretty much leave your decoy and attack the tower as much as you like, teleport back to safety or to your fountain, and then rinse and repeat. That way, it was just able to. So, there you go. There you go. Oh, baby, damn. I don't care. I was able to hit the tower. That's all I wanted. I know that he's gonna build full defense. Okay, that's that. It brings me back to my point. It's very shitty, I guess, to just abuse the fact that you can just go full defense and do well, okay, without having to worry about anything, because you just get defense and too bad, right? You don't have to worry about anything else. But you also have to be smart of whatever you're doing. For example, the champion that I have already is fucking OP, right? So if you abuse the things that he can do, what you can do is pretty amazing, you know? Like this. I'm gonna destroy the tower. I don't care about it. And see? Again, go for the stun. He comes to us, go for the stun. See? No problem. You wanna come for me? Now he's trying to do the same. But he's too, he's not gonna do well if he tries to do the same thing that I'm doing. Because if you compare my build to his build, it's very different. For example, the first thing that you have to know is that I am not building full defense. I'm just carrying this build. I actually, if I think about it, I would like to get rid of this and get this one, absolutely. And the next one is gonna be Blade of Energy. Okay, there you go. So you pretty much make a build of whatever you understand of the champion. And that's what I'm doing. Instead of going full defense, I am just abusing the things that he can do, because he can pretty much spam abilities and not have much problems. Like, she's just there. He's just there. Okay, I got it. Okay, now my hits are gonna hit triple. Look at that. Am I enjoying this fucking game, guys? Look. Look. What do you think about this? Look, and the ultimate, bro. This is when you use the ultimate. Whenever you have everything like this. Take it! No, he survived! Well, whatever. Look. Yeah. Oh, are you gonna use your ultimate? Okay, so you have to understand what your champion does, right? To be able to excel whenever you use the champion. Like right here, just gonna punish him. He's gonna come to me, come to the tower, make him slow, rinse and repeat. He's trying to run away. What do? Rinse and repeat. Let's go, baby. Let's go, baby. The thing is that going full defense is not always the way to go. You have to think about the things that your champion can do. Your champion is very good. This champion has a lot of base defense, so getting all defensive items is not gonna help him much. You have to have some kind of utility, right? The way that I like. Oh, shit. Never mind, guys. Oh, I forgot. Damn, guys. Sorry. I just went on my thing. So,
what should I get next?
I'm gonna go through his not armor penetration. Like, you only need one defensive item, really. Like, this defensive item is gonna help me against his flame armor. If he doesn't have minions, he can take my tower. Because he doesn't have any power.
Did he buy any power?
No, he should not be able to do it. Of course not. Of course not. He didn't do anything to my tower. Okay. Now, we're gonna fight again, right? Because now it's getting personal, right? So, we have our bubble, which is pretty good. There you go. It's always good to hit him whenever you have all the minions. Alright, there you go. You save your stun. Instead of wasting your stun every single time, I'd rather just have it whenever I want to secure a kill. It will be just a waste to be spamming that ability to have just more damage into a full defense build. They now have Power of the Gods, which is a very good choice on this champion because of this. It seems to be working like an AoE as well. The damage that you do, just crazy. Look at this. Just end up the game. That's 1/4 of the core. I don't know. From my perception, it could be, I don't know, more, 30%, maybe. So yeah, it's just abuse. I guess the champions. For example, Mikiri, it's already fucking stupid, right? He doesn't need energy to attack. He doesn't need mana. He doesn't need anything other than the cooldown. So what people do in order to abuse that, they build cooldown on that champion. The ultimate, it's like 30 some seconds. Imagine that with also the cooldown reduction. I don't know the exact number of the cooldown that it has, but it's already being like really cheap from what you already can do. So I'm gonna add that person as well. So yeah, I used to play this champion a long time ago, and honestly, it was just nice. It was just amazing, great. Like that champion is very strong. Where is he? I wanted to send him a message because the fight, it was a very good fight. It was this guy? No. Never mind that. So yeah, the whole purpose of the video, it was just because I wanted to show you some pictures, some images. That's something that I'll be doing tomorrow, I believe, because I'll be having tomorrow off, and right now, I don't have enough time to do it. So. I am going to go ahead and get some screenshots of the images, right? Or some images saved into a video so that I can show you all of the new skins that will be included in Season 2. Ace Arenas is going to be having an event from what I have seen on the Chinese server, which is called the Ace of Arena Season 2. I don't know the exact name, because I don't speak Chinese, right? Again, random. And in that page, I was able to find all this information that the Season 2 is gonna change a lot of things. Like the map that you have right now, I don't think that forest is gonna be kept. But there is going to be another map. I think it's an additional map, or it could replace the one that we have. But it looks insane, guys. It looks very beautiful. I actually would love to show you a video, but right now I don't know where that is. I found it while I was at work. And I didn't bother. Oh my god, really? Her? So yeah, I'm going to end up with that. I just wanted to show you all of the things that will be added to the game. There will be another two champions will be added to the game. I don't know the names of the champions. One is a warrior and the other one is a mage. The mage seems to be pretty amazing, and the warrior, I am going to buy it. And I'll allow you to see at least the game footage, right? Right now, we went random and we got... We got,
which is what?
What's her name? Sasha? Natasha. There you go. Natasha. So right now we're gonna be able to use Natasha. She's actually a champion that I do like. This is the guy that builds defense. That's true. Oh my god. That fucking sucks. Sucks. But oh well. Let's see if we can get some minion kills, right?
We're gonna need to level up as fast as possible.
We're gonna need boots. Oh, never mind. If I'm careful, I could only need this.
Oh. Okay, oh guys, one thing that I wanted to mention is that I've been trying to look for a main ADC. Oh baby, I almost got him. Oh, I almost got him. Give them a break. Easy break. So yeah, I've been trying to get a ADC champion. And I am going to be honest, I have been playing Natasha for a bit. And I am trying to improve. Of course, I need a lot of work. But I seem to have figured out some playstyles that may help me in the future. Like, you can play like a true sniper. First, you can make a barrier like this. So whenever you have people spamming at you like this, it's not going to matter much, right? Damn, that was nasty. So he's gonna be one of those people. That was very good punishment. Okay, I think this guy is gonna be stunning pretty often. I'm gonna be honest. I forgot what he does now. What's his name? Musaya. I forgot what Musaya does now. I'm honestly lost in that. There you go. Now, so you can play pretty much like a sniper. You see them come to you. He's gonna go for the multiple. He's using the ultimate. So we don't want any engagement, right?
Why?
Why would you want to engage right now?
What will be next?
Yeah, I like this.
Oh yeah, so I
can't make videos like this, guys. Sorry.
So yeah, I've been trying to get an ADC champion, and I think that Natasha could be it, because a lot of people are gonna hate me for this, but I don't like archers because
Because I think they're very easy to use. There, I said it. I don't even like to learn them, okay? Because, let's see.
Well, they're not easy to use
or to level.
The thing is that they rely too much on their items, that you have to worry too much about having to last hit minions, having to always make sure that you have the extra gold that you need because of this and that. Just things like that.
It's getting pretty cold outside, guys.
Sorry.
I think I can get this one as well.
You can't escape my bullets.
We just put it right here. Put it here. Go to him. Come to me.
Come to me. There you go.
What happened?
Well, you have to take in consideration many things, and I honestly don't like to do it. I just like to enjoy the game and just play, right?
But Natasha seems to be like a mix, because you have to use your abilities wisely, and then you have to use your abilities to your advantage, because the ways in which you have to escape an engagement that you don't want, it's to use your second and your first ability, because you're gonna make the enemy slow, and on top of that, oh baby, was that a mistake or no?
Ah!
Oh, he made it. But yeah, the way that you use your abilities is going to be always to your advantage, right? So if you make your enemies slow and then, oh, I need more speed. Let's see. What else can we get? Should I get... Oh yeah, baby.
This is why I don't like this. Oh, he made it.
Yeah, I did allow him to punish me like that. So,
1850.
So I should be able to get it.
There you go. So at least we got Power of the Gods, and he has that. So he's going for lifesteal. But doesn't he already have like some sort of lifesteal? I remember something like that. Well, we're not gonna let the same mistake happen twice. We're just gonna keep our distance. We're gonna clear. Like right there, he's there. No, he's there. So we're gonna lead to this. We're gonna lead to this. See? So he only engages. If nothing happens, he goes back. It seems like that. But we're gonna punish his tower, right? Again, every time that you play, you have to take advantage of whatever champion you're using. In this case, I have this new playstyle of just poking. Because it's very secure for me. Because my game, my phone doesn't work, and so I can't be as aggressive or play as I would like to. Nice.
That was good for us.
That's very important, because now we know that they're there, right? He's afraid, which is good. He should be. Right? Right, guys? He's not even there. Oh, he was there. Okay, we're gonna punch the tower. 1, 2, 3. Damn.
Let's go. We almost took down the tower. Should I get more attack speed? Yeah, I'm gonna get more attack speed. Yeah, I'm gonna keep the same boots because the stun rate is not good. We're gonna use this time mines to check. There you go. I think I'm getting the hang of how I can actually just... there you go. How I can use the abilities. I'm trying my best to learn how to play even like this, right? Because it interests me. He was punished. There you go, tower. We took the tower. There you go. Oh, that's a good, but we don't want to get close to him. We're not trying to do that. So we're gonna poke him down again. Once he goes back, we'll try to go for the... This time I'll use my abilities to check. It seems that he's not here. He's there. I'm gonna try to keep that one ability. Oh, he already used his ultimate. He's ready to engage. But we're also ready to punish, right? And there you go. And let's say, look at... Look at this, guys. The damage they'll do to the tower. Imagine that to a player. Just once. Damn. The power of the build that I have. You just needed that penetration, right? Because to my understanding, cores do have penetration. So I got the armor pen. So guys, yeah, I'll be showing you some videos also of the new champions. They're gonna be pretty much like the cinematic. If you haven't seen it, maybe you have. But yeah, or maybe I should just leave a link so that you can just go watch on your own, because you'll be like getting credit, right? Yeah, I'll just do that instead. So I will still show you the skins. I just wanted to play for you guys without worries, and that's what I did. So if you did enjoy it, very good, guys. Enjoy the rest of your night, and thank you so much for watching this video. And if you stayed up to the... How many minutes is it? Up to whatever minutes it is. It should be like 20, 30 minutes. Thank you. Have a nice day, guys.